Now, who else wants to play Mortal Kombat after that? Because I kind of do. Mortal Kombat stars Louis Tan as MMA fighter Cole Young, who is invited to fight alongside Earth's greatest champions, all with special powers of their own, against the enemies of the Outworld, who want to claim Earth as their own and enslave humanity. Now, let's face the facts. Video game movie adaptations have never really been that good, you know, with the exception of Tomb Raider 2018 and Detective Pikachu, which I thought were pretty decent movies. And there have also been like two past Mortal Kombat movies that were released in 1994 and 1997, if I believe so, which I have heard were pretty bad, even though I've never watched them. But I have to say, this movie wasn't half bad, but it could have been way better, I thought. First of all, I gotta say, I really enjoyed that opening scene, which is also available on YouTube, oddly enough. The first 7 minutes of the movie is available on YouTube, for those of you who don't know. I personally didn't watch it, like it released, what, a day ago before it released? I didn't watch it because I wanted to just wait. That's the reason why I never watch or never want to watch movie trailers before movies, because I always want to kind of like not spoil myself and just wait and just experience it, all of it, like at first hand. And that opening scene really set the tone for the rest of the movie and offered some really interesting backstory as well. But honestly, that's all that happens in the movie emotionally. Like, I didn't really care for any of the other characters in the movie that much, like Cole Young, his daughter, his wife, not even the guy who got his arms brutally frozen by Sub-Zero. Now, I, for one, am not a big fan of Mortal Kombat. Like, it's not that I don't like the games, it's just that I never really play them because I'm much more of a Tekken guy. I have seen what they're about though, so it's not like I'm going through this completely blind, it's just that I don't really know too much about the story in those games. So take over what you will, but I feel like you would feel like more strongly about this movie, either like it a lot or hate it a lot, if you're like a big fan of the games and you know the games very well. Like, if you're into the games, like, you know all the characters and whether they're casted well or not. For example, Kano, oh man, wow. Being someone who doesn't really know that much about Kano, I feel like he was just there as comedic relief and nothing else. Like, most, if not all of his lines were just one-liners, which is, it's kind of fine, right? And it was also kind of funny because, you know, I'm Australian and he had a really strong Australian accent, like he just sounded like a straight up bogan. But like a lot of people, they were laughing like really hard, even though it wasn't actually that funny to an extent where you have to be like bellowing laughing, and that came out to be kind of cringy. So I can see how a lot of people might find this movie to be kind of cringy just because of that specific character. It just reminds me of those laugh tracks, the way the people in the theaters were laughing. Like, you ever hear those laugh tracks in like sitcoms where it's like they're laughing just unexpectedly, like in Mr. Bean, for example? Not to say that Mr. Bean is like terrible, I love Mr. Bean, but sometimes when they're laughing, when it's not actually that funny, it comes off a little bit cringy, and I kind of found it to that effect here. Like, I didn't know that I was walking into a comedy. Is that like what Mortal Kombat is about? Like, there was a big disconnect between the opening few scenes where it was semi action packed and kind of serious to a bunch of scenes that were only there to kind of like for comedic purposes. And at one point I was like, where's the action? Where's it? And when the action came, oh man, was it good. Now, the story is pretty generic. I mean, it's just a bunch of guys forming an alliance, finding their powers, and just fighting bad guys who wants to take over Earth. We've heard this a million times, but, you know, obviously with these type of movies, the story isn't the most important part. So we kind of all knew that, like, coming into it anyway. And despite this being a 2-hour movie, it really didn't feel that long. Probably because not a lot of things happened. Because, you know, I feel like they could have made use of the characters a lot more and show more of what they could do. But I feel like they're just saving a lot of stuff for like the future movies if they decide to go down that path and if this movie does very well, which I don't know if they're gonna make more of these, but I mean, I'm down. But I mean, when it got down to the actual fighting, it was really awesome, and I especially loved the Scorpion versus Sub-Zero fight, the big showdown that, you know, was teased in the trailer as well. That was really, really fun to watch, and I imagine it'd be even funner, like, for people who are really into Mortal Kombat as well. I just wanted more of it though, and the fatalities. Oh man. Guys, let me know, what was your favorite fatality? For me, it was the Kung Lao one with the razor hat, I don't know what it's called, but that splitting the body in half, that was fucking amazing. And here's the thing, right? I've seen Mortal Kombat and I know it's pretty fucking brutal, but this movie, in terms of the brutalness, the goriness, definitely does not meet the expectations of the game. I feel like this movie, and I was expecting it to be much more brutal, to have much more fatalities, and to be much more gory, but yeah. Now, with one point of this movie, it just felt very throwaway with the script. It just felt very one-dimensional and very predictable. Like, it was just all these guys fighting each other. But it's like we know who they're gonna fight. Like, oh, you fight this guy, you fight this guy, me and you, yeah, let's fight those guys. And at that point, I feel like most people already know that they're not gonna lose because they're the good guys. So it's like there's not really a lot of drama or tension. Ultimately, I didn't hate this movie. I did enjoy it to some extent, but I just feel like it could have been so much better. So for me, it was kind of a letdown. I'm going to give Mortal Kombat a B minus. But only because the fight scenes were really fucking amazing. But I just wish that there was more of them and that they were more brutal. I needed more fatalities. But anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. Let me know what you think down below. Like and sub if you enjoyed, and as always, feel free to check out any of my previous videos. Until next time.